This is Aisha. She came to Norway 2 years ago. It has been difficult to be alone in a new country, and she's very tired. Sometimes, Aisha thinks that she's unable to take care of her children, Hassan and Joseph, and that they deserve more. One of the daycare employees asks Aisha if she's struggling and informs that there is a place where she can get support and help. She also offers to come along if Aisha wishes. Aisha is scared and uncertain about what to do, but eventually decides to call the child welfare service. There are many reasons why a family may need help. This is Sarah and her parents. She has made friends after they came to Norway. The friends gather after school, but Sarah's father refuses her to join them. He wants control of everything she does and keeps her confined indoors. During an argument between them, he slaps her on her cheek. Sarah tells her friend that she's angry, since her father never lets her go out, and that she feels sad when her parents argue. They decide to talk with a child and youth worker at the center. She tells Sarah that it's not okay for Sarah to be in such a situation. They agree that she contact the child welfare services so that the family may receive help. Aisha is very nervous, but the contact person comforts her, saying that they have no intention of taking her children. She says that the responsibility of the child welfare service is to ensure that all children in Norway are safe from harm, and that the most important thing they do is to help families so that they can be happy together. Aisha says that she finds it difficult to be alone and that she misses her family and homeland. She has trouble sleeping because of painful memories visiting her at night, and she's worried about the future. At the center, a person from the child welfare services visits. She says that parents may draw boundaries for the children, but not by hitting or isolation, and adds that friendships are important for children's development. Therefore, they wish to ensure that the family is okay and that Sarah receives good care. She wishes to speak both with Sarah, her parents, and the family together. Sarah's father says he wants to protect Sarah and is afraid of what may happen to her in Norway. Her mother is in despair and tired of arguing with her husband. After the child welfare services have talked with Aisha and the boys and have gathered information from the school and daycare, they agree on how they can assist the family. Aisha receives help and someone to talk to. The boys will be visiting a family some weekends so that Aisha can regain her energy. The child welfare service cover the expenses so that Hassan can play football with his new friends. Now that Aisha has regained some energy, Hassan doesn't have to worry about his mother or take responsibility for his little brother. All of which makes Aisha and the boys do much better together. At Sarah's, the parents receive help so that they and Sarah can talk and improve their understanding of each other, and assisting the parents in solving problems more calmly. Her father is able to draw boundaries and also listen to Sarah's wishes and acknowledging her needs to be with her friends. The Child Welfare Service in Norway shall ensure that children are safe and receive help, care and protection.